children. In the last class, we have discussed about the characteristics of synthetic fiber and different synthetic fibers and their uses. In today's class, we'll discuss about the next very important small topic in this chapter, that is about the plastic. You know that we are using different types of plastic materials in our daily life and day-to-day life. In our home or in kitchen or in any field, we are using many plastic materials or materials or articles made by plastic. And because of its property as well as because of its characteristics or nature, the plastic has got many uses in the different field. But this is not good for environment, and it is not environmental friendly material. We'll discuss that thing in the next class. Okay. What is plastic then? Plastic, it is also a polymer like a synthetic fibers. You know about that synthetic fiber? They are made up of many units, the many small units combined to form a large unit. Like this, plastic is also a polymer like a synthetic fiber. All plastics do not have the same type of arrangement of units. You will come across different types of plastics in different shape and in different size because of this arrangement of units in the plastic. They will get different shape, different size, as well as different property of plastic because of its arrangement of units in the plastic material. In some articles or in some plastic articles, units are arranged like a straight chain, that is in the form of linear. And in some articles, they are arranged like cross-linked. This is, you consider these are one-one unit. They are arranged cross-linked. They are cross-linked and they will give different shape to the plastic article. There are some, in some material they are arranged in the linear form and some they are arranged in the cross-linked form. Plastic articles are having different size and shape because of its property. We can give shape and size to the plastic based on its property. Because of this nature, the plastic is used everywhere and it is having a variety of use in different fields. Plastic articles are available in different shape and sizes because plastic is easily moldable. Moldable means what? It can be changed into any shape. It can be shaped in any form. It can be recycled, reused, colored, and melted, rolled into sheets or made into wires. The plastic can be made into wire, made into sheets. It can be melted and it can be colored. It can be reused and it can be recycled. Because of its nature, the plastic is used in many fields. Example of plastic, very important example, very commonly used example of plastic is polythene. You heard about that polythene bag we are using commonly for shopping and to carry the different materials. That is a polythene bag. It is made up of ethane molecules. Okay, many ethane molecules combined to form a polyethylene. It is a polymer. It is example for polymer. It is used to make polythene bags, commonly used polythene bag that is made by a polythene. It is an example for, very good example for plastic. Depending on the characteristics or depending on the nature of the plastic, and they are classified into different types. Mainly they are classified into two types of plastic based on the nature, whether they can be melt, whether they melt on heating or not, whether they set on heating or not. Based on that, they are classified into two types. One is thermoplastic, another one is thermosetting plastic. There are two types of plastic. One is thermoplastic, another one is thermosetting plastic. What is the meaning of thermoplastic? The plastic which gets deformed easily on heating and can be bent easily are known as thermoplastics. Okay, the plastic which gets deformed, that means change their shape, deform easily on heating. When you apply the heat, they change their shape easily and they can bend easily. Some plastic material you can see, you can bend easily. But some plastic material you cannot bend easily. When you bend that one, they will break. Okay, that is a different type of plastic. These thermoplastics are the plastics which gets deformed easily on heating and can be bent easily are known as thermoplastic. Example for thermoplastics or thermoplastics are very important example, that is polythene and PVC. You heard about PVC pipes and all. That is polyvinyl chloride. Full form of PVC is polyvinyl chloride. There are many vinyl chloride molecules combined to give what? Polyvinyl chloride. This is an example for a thermoplastic. Polythene and PVC are the examples for thermoplastics. These are used, this the polythene as well as PVC are used in manufacturing toys, combs and variety of for various types of containers. To make different types of container, these thermoplastics are used. Next, another one type of plastic, that is thermosetting plastic. What is the meaning of this thermosetting plastic? The plastics which when molded once cannot be softened by heating. They set on heating and you cannot get back. Again, you cannot deform that one. You cannot change the shape of that plastic. When you heat that one and mold that one, again you cannot change that plastic. The plastics which when molded once cannot be softened by heating. Again, they will not melt. Those type of plastics are called as thermosetting plastics. What are they called? Thermosetting plastic. Example, very good example is bakelite and melamine are the very good examples of thermosetting plastic. This bakelite you can see in the handles of cooking wares. You will go in cooker and all, you will come across them handles are they made up of bakelite, black color. They are water fire resistance. Bakelite and water melamine are the examples for thermosetting plastic. This bakelite is a poor conductor of heat and electricity. It is a poor conductor. It will not conduct heat as well as it will not allow the electricity to pass through them easily. That's why it is a poor conductor of heat and electricity. That's why it is used for making electrical switches, handles of various utensils. That's why this bakelite is used in the preparation of all these electric switches and handles of various utensils or various kitchen wares. Next, another one example of thermosetting plastic, that is melamine. It is resistant to fire and it tolerate heat. It is resistant to fire as well as it can tolerate heat. That's why it is used in floor tiles, kitchenware, as well as in the preparation of fabrics that can resist fire. Even fire extinguisher in that field and all, they will wear cloths that will not catch fire. The type of cloth preparation, these plastics are used which resist fire. The fabrics which resist fire in that preparation, those preparation, this melamine plastic is used. It is an example for thermosetting plastic. Thermoplastic plastic as well as thermosetting plastic. There are two types of plastic, that is thermoplastic, another one is thermosetting plastic. Example for thermosetting plastics are bakelite and melamine. Example for thermoplastics are water, polythene as well as PVC. These are the examples. You have to remember this type and the differences between this thermoplastic as well as thermosetting plastic and uses of all these things and the examples and the definition of all these types of plastic. It is very important types of plastic. Because of its property, it is used in a variety of field. That's why nowadays plastic is preferred because of its different property characteristics. We'll discuss in the next class, that is lightweight and easy to carry, all those things. A variety of designs you will get, variety of shapes you can get. Because of all those things, we are using the plastic material. But one thing that is not environmental friendly, you have to keep in your mind while using the plastic articles, because it is difficult to decompose. Okay, it takes several years to decompose. The other things we will discuss in the next class. If you have any doubt, you can ask. Thank you.